Hadouken here is probably the most iconic move in fighting game history, I think. Here is the Hadouken. As you can see, I can do the player 1 Hadouken. Here is player 2 Hadouken. And I visualize the input buffer at the top. Here is the input buffer for player 1. Here's the input buffer for player 2. The input buffer is just a vector. I'm gonna quit the game, see if I can find the input element. So all I'm doing is saving this little piece of data, or an entire series of this little piece of data, into a vector. And on every frame, I look at the vector and see if you've done a special move or not. So let me play the game again. And just like last time, we have the editor. It's working pretty well. The basic punch from video number 1. The thing about the input buffer is that on every 120th frame, which means 1 second in this game, if 120 frames has passed for every input element, then I remove it from the vector. And that's pretty much it. So things are relatively simple in terms of the input or your combos or the input vector. One thing that I didn't expect with the buffer is that sometimes, let's say you're trying to do the Hadouken as fast as possible, something like this happens. Do you see the buffer? Didn't happen this time. That. I think this happens a lot with the keyboard, and probably less so with the joystick, because with the keyboard, when you're trying to do a down forward right here, you have to press two buttons at the same time, and the act of letting go of the down key alone means you're pressing forward. So if I do something like this, or let me try again. Okay, there's a weird timing where you're letting go of the down key and then pressing forward. What happens is that when you try to do Hadouken as fast as you can, sometimes you press punch as you're letting go of the down forward key or the down key. It's not happening this time. It's a very edge case. Sometimes the punch key ends up being in front of your last forward key. This isn't all that serious, since later I'm going to implement joystick controls as well, but it was something unexpected. And just like any other, or just like any project, a lot of unexpected problems occur, and you're going to be spending a lot of time trying to solve those unexpected problems. In this case, it's a minor issue, a very small edge case. So probably additional code, or I might even have to fix how the input is taken into account. But it's definitely doable, but it's just something that's on my, somewhere in the middle of my to-do list. Right now, what's more important is the core game mechanics. And let me see if I can... So right now, I don't have collision between the player body mass itself. I have collision between the body parts. But when it comes to collision between the players, you can see that I'm walking right through the opponent. This doesn't make any sense at all. So stuff like this is closer to the core game mechanics, and that's what's on top of my update list in terms of the priority. I haven't decided how I'm going to do the body mass collision. Usually, for most games, there's somewhat a rectangle that represents the general mass of the character, and these rectangles are not supposed to overlap with each other most of the time. For something like Street Fighter 2, where I'm taking a lot of reference from, there is a bit of overlap when, if you jump up when you're coming down, if you ever try to land on top of your opponent, instead of bouncing, landing and then bouncing off like Mario, your opponent sort of slides away from you and then you land. So after that split second of overlap, there's no more collision between the two box colliders for the character. I haven't decided how I'm going to approach this. Mostly because I have never built a fighting game before, and I don't know if there's any best practice for doing stuff like this. I have a general plan, but a lot of the things, a lot of details, a lot of game mechanics, I'm making stuff up as I go along. And I think that's also what makes indie games fun and interesting to make. I think there's a fine balance between over planning and no planning at all, trying to get to somewhere that's optimal for me, that's more fun for me. Basically, I'm going to run many experiments, and I might even try to have the Mario style jumping on your opponent, damage or bounce off, you know, stuff like that. I'm going to run experiments, or I might decide to go with the traditional Street Fighter 2 style collision system. Either way, I think making changes along the way. As long as you're not going too far away from the initial plan, I think it's fine. And I think it's also what makes indie games fun and interesting. Which reminds me of my other decision. You might be wondering why I'm drawing my own stuff even though I'm not an artist. I could have used the existing sprites. It's very easy to find sprite sheets for some of the older games, some of the older fighting games. I didn't choose to use those because even though they're easy to implement, once you see something that you're very used to from an old game, there's sort of an expectation on how your game is supposed to be played. And I didn't want any of my game design to have a predetermined path. I wanted to take reference from Street Fighter 2, but at the same time, I also want to add a lot of my own little taste to it, my own little game mechanics and so on. So that's why I'm using these, don't judge my art, these maybe ugly sprites. But of course I might later hire an artist. Or another option that I'm considering in terms of the graphics is that, I don't know if you played something like Thomas Was Alone. I think it's an indie game, but there's a lot of indie games where the storytelling is driven by abstract shapes, shadows, silhouettes, color contrast, rather than using the traditional 2D or 3D graphics. So it's somewhat minimal, but you can still tell a story using primitive abstract shapes. I might try to go for that. I might try to have something like a city background sunset and the silhouettes of the characters. Something minimal. Again, this isn't something that's decided. It's just something that I'm considering. I'm going to run many tests and see what works out for me. So right now I'm happy with the input buffer. It's working pretty well, other than the little bug that I mentioned. And the next priority is getting the body collisions, things like the air-to-air collisions, air-to-ground collisions, ground-to-air collisions, ground-to-ground collisions. There's many different circumstances. So those stuff is what's on my mind. Those stuff need to be taken care of next. And that's pretty much it. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, you can reach me on my Discord server. All the links are in the description. Goodbye.